Creation of the position of powerful prime minister is one of the key recommendations given to a team tasked by President Uhuru Kenyatta and opposition leader Raila Odinga to receive public submissions towards ending cycle of electoral violence. Submissions to the Building Bridges Initiative BBI suggest the clamor to amend the constitution to overhaul the country's governance system, including creation of the post of executive prime minister, is gathering steam. Those who back a referendum to achieve this want powers of the president to be trimmed and be checked by an expanded executive and a powerful parliamentary system. Mzee Jomo Kenyatta was the country's first prime minister in 1963, but he thereafter became president after the country became a republic. The last attempt to reintroduce the prime minister's post was during the 2005 referendum through the Bomas draft, which was however watered down to a version backed by the then government. Uhuru and Raila, who were in the Orange Team at the time, successfully campaigned for the defeat of the Waqo draft, named after the then Attorney General Amos Waqo. The nine-member task force chaired by Garissa Senator Yusuf Haji, with Professor Adams Olu deputizing him, has so far been to seven counties, namely Nairobi, Machakos, Kitui, Tharaka Nithi, Embu, Makueni and Meru. Today, the BBI task force opens public hearings by meeting residents of Isiolo and Masarbit. Haji will lead a team to Isiolo while Olu will lead another team to Masarbit. The two groups will reunite and head to Samburu tomorrow and thereafter receive presentations by residents of Lake Hippia County on Thursday. Presentations by Central Organization of Trade Unions COTU, governors, senators, MPs, members of County Assembly MCAs and the public in general are unanimous that the country's governance system has to be changed. During his presentation in Nairobi last month, COTU Secretary General Francis Atwoli called for an amendment to the constitution to create the position of Prime Minister and two deputies who will oversee and supervise the day-to-day running of government. He argued that a parliamentary system of governance is the best as it aligns the governance structure to the changing socio-economic and political dynamics, including the aspect of creating a government that is all-inclusive and resonates well with majority of Kenyans, if not all. He proposed an amendment to Article 154(1) to create the position of a chief secretary who will be in charge of overall government administration and sit as a member of the cabinet. Equally, an amendment to Chapter 9(9) on the Executive, Part 2(2) under Article 131(1) to create the position president with two deputies to reduce the anxiety that comes with a single deputy to the president being viewed as the next president upon the end of term of the serving president, Atwoli said.